नमस्ते, माय नेम इज़ JVN ऋषि गौतम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जर्नलिज्म। टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ इवॉल्विंग इंटरनेट इन इंडिया। वुड परहैप्स नॉट रियलाइज दैट कंपेयर्ड टू इंडियाज़ 70 ईयर्स ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस, द इंटरनेट इन द कंट्री इज़ relatively young at 31st. It even celebrates its public birthday on 15th August. While the origins of the global internet date back to the 1960s, India first went online only when the Educational Research Network, ERNET, a joint undertaking of the Department of Electronics and the United Nations Development Program, UNDP, was launched in 1986. Back then, the internet was only meant for the use of educational and research communities. Even when cyberspace was first thrown open to the public in India on 15th August 1995 by Videsh Sanchar Nigam Limited, VSNL, now known as Tata Communications Limited, we used to access the internet using a modem, short for modulator, demodulator, a device that enabled a computer to transmit data over telephone or cable lines by converting analog signals into digital ones. The modem was not an easy beast to tame. It would emit a gargling sound and not connect easily with the telephone line. One had to repeatedly dial to make a connection with the bigger computer network of the internet services provider. Moreover, there was no guarantee that you would get to surf the web without interruptions even when it connected finally. People who helped make the internet become a reality in India included VSNL chairman BK Sanyal, BK Singhal, Amitav Kumar, Director of Technology at VSNL, tech evangelists like Kanaka Sabapathi Pandian, Maihar Mafatlal, Vijay Mukhi, and the late Bollywood actor Shammi Kapoor. India was also fortunate that by the time the internet was thrown open to the public, the World Wide Web had matured and we had access to web browsers such as Mosaic and Netspace Navigator, both now part of internet history. The Gateway Internet Access Service of VSNL was first opened in Bombay, now Mumbai, Delhi, Calcutta, now Kolkata, and Madras, now Chennai. The service was soon expanded to include Bangalore, and Pune by the end of 1995. However, the official launch of the internet for the Indian public ended up being a big goof up, as VSNL had no estimation about the hidden demand coupled with hardware and network issues. However, post the botched launch, VSNL was able to add 10,000 internet users in just 6 months. A year later, software services lobby body NASCOM set up a booth for VSNL at the Nehru Center in Mumbai to demonstrate what the internet can do. Integrated services, digital networks, SS was introduced in 1997, and the internet subscriber base touched about 90,000 in March 1998. In 2004, the government formulated its broadband policy, which defined broadband as an always-on internet connection with download speed of 256 kbits or above. In 2010, the government auctioned 3G spectrum, followed by the auction of 4G spectrum that accelerated the pace of the wireless broadband market. Today, we access the internet in our offices, at home, in the 70,000 odd cyber cafes that still exist in remote areas, common service centers, and at modern cafes, railway stations, and other public spots that have open Wi-Fi hotspots, and on our smartphones. We use a variety of technologies and media, including dial-up, coaxial cables, Ethernet, ISDN, 3G, and 4G. Thank you.